Ganslati, a former assemblyman-in-law, is about driving his new car home from the premises of the Driver and Vehicle Licensing Authority. He just registered it, and he's impressed with the services rendered by the authority.
Because with the fact that we have all the requirements that they needed, everything is okay for us. I'll take this opportunity to thank the government that, yes, is trying to fix, you know, this thing so that those Kalabule guys or Guru boys will be, you know, exempted from the system.
Typically, within first week of every new year, hundreds of persons troop to the DVLA and its accredited registration centers across the country to register their cars for customized and unique number plates. Surprisingly, the situation was not as such this year. The roads were free of traffic and the premises appeared less busy. Nana Obri Yebua, an insurance operator near the authority, explains why.
It's not like the previous years that people troop in for their registrations. If people come here a day before the registration, but right now, because of the garages that is being spread around, so people go in to that places to do their registration.
Francis Asamoah-Tufuo, public relations manager for the DVLA, confirms Nana Obri Yebua's analysis and says effective measures, including an initial online registration and creation of new registration centers at various locations, are in place, thus making the registration process faster than it used to be.
It's been okay yesterday, and we are hoping that day two, compared to yesterday, is a bit okay, and we hope that by day three and or by close of this week, everything will be okay.
He, however, cautions prospective clients to be on the lookout for fraudulent guru boys.
Should be very wary with these guru guys. This is a peak period, and you see them patrolling around, and we have warned them severally, but of course we have to caution our clients that don't give your documents to them. If you are not careful, you'll be shortchanged. You give them your documents and they'll just go somewhere else and give you fake documents.
From 37 in Accra, this is Gabriel Ni Obodai Togbo Ashon reporting for Metro News.